Hello everyone and welcome to another Dash Cam Owners Australia review. Today we're having a look at the Mini 0803 from digcams.com. I put a link for them down in the description if you wish to check out the site. So this camera retails for about $95 Australian, with an optional $10 more for the GPS version. The model we're taking a look at today is the non-GPS version. Alright, so we're going to start off with a few features of this camera. It comes with your standard things like event, G-sensor recording, it's got a parking and photo modes. One of the differences with this camera, it actually records in 1296p as an option. Then you've also got your standard 1080p, 720p and 30 frames per second. It's quite a small camera, which you'll see in a minute. The specs are 72mm by 45mm by 60mm. It's got a 135 degree viewing angle. It's got a 1.5 inch LCD screen. And it supports micro SD cards up to 32 gigabytes. So we'll get stuck into it now and take a look. Here's the camera itself, as you can see. Nice, very small model. Very compact. All black, very easy to hide in the car. What you also get in the box, instruction manual. What we have here is a HDMI adapter, so you can connect the camera straight to the TV. USB cable, the mount for the windscreen. Cigarette charger plug. And finally, an RCA cable. Alright, so now we're going to take a look around the camera, see what the layout is. Here we have the front view, we've got our lens, and of course our mount for mounting it to the windscreen. Power button. On the rear side we have our LCD screen, simple three button recording with the status LED. On the bottom we've got our HDMI and SD card. On the top got our charging and RCA connector. So very simple unit, not much you can really mess around with there. Alright, now we're going to turn it on and have a look through the menus, since this camera does actually have an inbuilt battery. Nice view of the screen there. Pretty clear considering the small size of the screen. If we go into the menus, right, as you can see, here's our main menu. All our options. We got resolution. So we got a few different options here. 1080, 720. Back to 1296. Quality options. Got normal. Super fine and fine. Then we got our other options. AE meter mode, wide dynamic range. Flicker options for selecting hertz rate, white balance. There's actually quite a lot of different options for getting the clarity just right on this camera. So you got your recycle, which selects your video recording times, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 1 minute, off. Motion detection options, time setup. You can program a driver number, the stamp onto the video here. So if you want to select what car you're driving or what vehicle it's come out of, you can program that in there. You got other settings here like the G sensor calibration, turn GPS on and off for that model. The GPS with this particular camera is just it's based inside the mount, so it's not actually a different camera for the GPS, you just require the mount that has the GPS capability. Then we've got our format and software version. There we go, nice and simple. Alright, now I'm going to start to show you some in-car footage and give you some audio from what it sounds like in the vehicle. As you could see from the night footage, it's really quite acceptable for a camera of this size. You could read the speed limits, and the light showed up pretty well from the headlights. Right now you can see it's a daytime video. Plenty of clarity here. You can read signs on buildings, license plate details, everything like that, nice and clear. As you would have noticed, the audio in the last clip as well was very clear. You could hear the radio in the background, car accelerating. For a camera of this size, I'm actually really quite impressed. As you see now, driving past these vehicles, you can read the license plates on them. If you stop and pause, you can read the details on the buildings. So for such a small camera, it certainly packs a punch. Very acceptable. Now I'm just going to show you what it looks like from outside the vehicle. Alright, here we have the camera installed in the car. Just in front of the rear view mirror. As you can see, it blends in pretty well from the outside. The only real reason it's showing up quite so well here is because I've got a flashlight basically pointed at it. As you can see, nice and out of the way. Behind the mirror where the driver can't see it, so it's out of sight, out of mind. And due to the fact that it does have an LCD screen, in New South Wales at least, it must not be viewable while you're driving. Okay, so all in all, I think for the price, this is one great camera. Not much I can really complain about apart from the mount, which feels a bit flimsy, but that's just going to be the nature of double-sided tape, essentially. So, thank you very much for listening to this review. This is Dash Cam Owners Australia. Alright, as you could see from the night footage, it's really quite acceptable for a camera of this size. You could read the speed limits, and the light showed up pretty well from the headlights. Right now you can see it's a daytime video, plenty of clarity here. You can read signs on buildings, license plate details, everything like that, nice and clear. As you would have noticed, the audio in the last clip as well was very clear. You could hear the radio in the background, car accelerating. For a camera of this size, I'm actually really quite impressed. As you see now, driving past these vehicles, you can read the license plates on them. If you stop and pause, you can read the details on the buildings. So for such a small camera, it certainly packs a punch. Very acceptable. Now I'm just going to show you what it looks like from outside the vehicle. Alright, here we have the camera installed in the car. just in front of the rear view mirror. As you can see, it blends in pretty well from the outside. The only real reason it's showing up quite so well here is because I've got a flashlight basically pointed at it. As you can see, nice and out of the way. Behind the mirror where the driver can't see it, so it's out of sight, out of mind. And due to the fact that it does have an LCD screen, in New South Wales at least, it must not be viewable while you're driving. Okay, so all in all, I think for the price, this is one great camera. Not much I can really complain about apart from the mount, which feels a bit flimsy, but that's just going to be the nature of double-sided tape, essentially. So, thank you very much for listening to this review. This is Dash Cam Owners Australia. Got normal, super fine and fine. Then we got our other options, AE meter mode, wide dynamic range, flicker options for selecting hertz rate, white balance. There's actually quite a lot of different options for getting the clarity just right on this camera. So you got your recycle, which selects your video recording times, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 1 minute, on, off. Motion detection options, time setup. You can program a driver number, the stamp onto the video here. So if you want to select what car you're driving or what vehicle it's come out of, you can program that in there. You got other settings here like the G sensor calibration, turn GPS on and off for that model. The GPS with this particular camera is just it's based inside the mount, so it's not actually a different camera for the GPS, you just require the mount that has the GPS capability. Then we've got our format and software version. There we go, nice and simple. Alright, now I'm going to start to show you some in-car footage and give you some audio from what it sounds like in the vehicle. Alright, as you could see from the night footage, it's really quite acceptable for a camera of this size. You could read the speed limits, and the light showed up pretty well from the headlights. Right now you can see it's a daytime video, plenty of clarity here, you can read signs on buildings, license plate details, everything like that, nice and clear. As you would have noticed, the audio in the last clip as well was very clear. You could hear the radio in the background, car accelerating.